One of the things that resonates most with India Arie's fans is her unapologetic embracing of her authentic self. It's one of the reasons her songs inspire and uplift us so much. So when this publicity photo was released for her new single, her fans cried foul and accused India of being a hypocrite by lightening her skin. Tempers flared and the claws came out on social media. She was called ugly, a sellout, a liar, and much, much worse.
People were cursing you.
And I'm not used to that. The people who have been my fans over the years have been so respectful that I almost feel like, wait a minute, y'all, I'm not all that.
But you're saying it didn't affect you as much, as deeply.
It did, at first, not at all. I was just excited, really. And then,
when people are cursing you, that feels bad.
That is when I started to get upset. And it wasn't about the thing. It was just the fact that you think you could talk to anyone like that.
Yes.
You know, and I was kind of like, why do you think you could talk to me like that? Yes. It was like that.
All because people thought you had lightened your skin.
Yeah, I still am dumbfounded by that.
It's because the album cover, I mean, I know what good lighting can do. Mm-hmm. So you look kind of golden-y compared to, let's say, the first album cover, mm-hmm. or you do. You look golden-y, mm-hmm. wouldn't you say?
Mm-hmm.
You look golden-y there.
And that was my intention.
In Song for Say, you, that to was look
my
golden-y.
Well, this is not my album cover, it's my single cover.
Okay.
Well, I don't know what they're gonna say about the album cover, we'll see. But what I wanted was to have gold skin, and if you see, the dress is gold fabric, it's metallic fabric, and the backdrop is metallic.
Uh-huh.
And I wanted for it to glow.
Uh-huh.
And be luminous,
uh-huh.
not light.
Yeah.
It was luminous, but for me, you know, there's that conversation where women's bodies are routinely just unpacked as entertainment. So there's that bikini body and post-baby body and mom boobs and all the stuff that they say and all that stuff. And for me, it was stepping out there and allowing myself to be beautiful and sensual and powerful and strong and athletic and womanly and all this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And just letting it be seen.
Showing
some skin and showing my thigh muscles and showing. Mm-hmm. That was my intention. I wasn't trying to look light. I was trying to look luminous.
Mm-hmm. And so when you all shot that photograph and with the gold background and the ha-da-ha-da-ha, it was lit in order to make you look luminous.
Yeah.
It wasn't, I'm trying to lighten my skin.
And that's what was hard for me to understand. And I have more clarity about it now. And it was really the Black community, of course, because this colorism conversation lives in the Black community.
That's right.
And I couldn't understand.
Because all the white people now are talking, what are you talking about? Yes.
Right, so there's that.
There's a colorism conversation that goes on all the time because within the Black community still, there is value placed on stemming from slavery and the slaves who were allowed to come into the master's house, into the big house, versus those who were in the field. There was a color line.
Right.
And the lighter your skin was, the closer you were to being white. And that
and a lot of times that color line was defined because maybe the slave master was your relative.
That's why you
so
had
you
that's
were lighter,
why you had the
and so you were treated better.
Now, what I understand when I heard that was happening is that if you were going to lighten your skin, people then feel abandoned and they feel like everything you've ever said
wasn't true.
That everything, all the lyrics, everything you've ever written, everything they believed you to be and held you up to be, then wasn't true. And if you'd lightened your skin, it wouldn't be.
I agree.
Yeah.
I agree. I feel there's two conversations for me. The colorism conversation for what I would, and this is my prayer, what I would love to see happen is that I find the perfect words or the perfect song to sing or to say to people that will heal a big part of this conversation in the Black community. Because really, it's about self-worth.
And as always, Yahweh, all day, every day. Peace.